सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनि व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पुरवेदाग्नोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुको शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नायान्तिकसंसिद्धमाधिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे So the 52nd sutra is introduced by Sadashiv Brahmendra as Purvottara Brahmanayoho Swatantra Vidya Vidhanat Madhyastasyapi Brahmanasya Swatantra Vidya Vidhiparatvam Ah. The Manasagnis are independent upasanas. In that context, what has gone by and what follows, when you look at them, Purva and Uttara Brahmanas, the earlier Brahmana and the next Brahmana that follows, if you look at them, they are what? Swatantra Vidyas. There is a Vidhana, Vidhi of Swatantra Vidya, Swatantra Upasanas. So the earlier Upasana to this Manasagni discussion and the later following, both are independent upasanas. So what is sandwiched between them? There is a nyaya which tells you that what is in between now is what? It has to be independent. So Swatantra Vidya Vidhanat Madhyastasyapi, what is in between this Manasagni upasana, that is, that Brahmana is also what? Swatantra Vidya. It is a vidhi. It is committed paratvam, swatantra vidhi vidya paratvam aha. So Bhagavan Sutrakara states that the middle section sandwiched between two independent upasanas is also committed to giving a vidhi of a vidya upasana, to prescribe an upasana which is swatantra, independent. And thereby the sutra parena cha shabdasya tadvidyam bhuyastvat त्वनुबंधः परेण च शब्दस्य ताद्विध्यं भूयस्त्वात् त्वनुबंधः परेण च शब्दस्य ताद्विध्यं भूयस्त्वात् तु अनुबंधः. सो द सूत्र सेज परेण च, सो देयरफॉर पूर्वेण परेण च, चकारात् पूर्वेण आल्सो, सो पूर्वेण परेण च ब्राह्मणे both the Brahmanas are what? Preceding and following. Shabdasya, or the Shabda meaning in that in both Brahmanas preceding and following, the Shabda, Shabdasya Tadvidyam. Shabdasya Tadvidyam means the Shruti, that is Shabda Pramana. Tadvidyam, what is it? Tadvidyam is Swatantra Vidyaparattam. Tadvidyam is, Tat means Swatantra. And Tad is Tadhita to that. Tadvidyam. Tadvidhi, Tadvida, and Tadvida, Tadhita of that which Shanj Pratyaya will give you, Tadvidyam. Meaning it is of that type. Which type? The same type that has been concluded in the earlier section. And if you analyze the following, it is also Swatantra. So Swatantra, which is seen in the earlier and the later Brahmana, the middle section also has Parenacha. Purvena Parenacha Brahmane Shabdasya Tadvidyam. Both are having independent upasanas. So the middle one will also have independent upasana. Then what is the sambandha with the karma? This has already been seen in the vritti, in the earlier sutras. The sutrakara himself says now, the anubandha though, the connection with the karma kanda, whereby the upasanas which are रिलेटेड टू मानसाग्नि कर्मांगानां मानसाग्नि विद्यायां संपाद्यानां तु भूयस्त्वात् बिकॉज देर आर लॉट ऑफ कर्मांगास विच हैव टू बी इमेजिन्ड इन दी मानसाग्नि कर्मांगास विच आर इन दी कर्म इन दी कर्मकांड एंड दी मानसाग्नि उपासना विद्या मानसाग्नि विद्या यू हैव टू इमेजिन ऑल दोस कर्मांगास देर फॉर वॉट दीज संपाद्यानां अग्निनाम ऑल दीज अग्निज विच हैव टू बी इमेजिन्ड ऑल इन दी उपासनास नॉट दी अग्निज अग्नि इत्यादि अग्नि एंड अदर थिंग्स कर्मांगास विच हैव टू बी मेडिटेटेड अपॉन इन दिस उपासना ऑल दोज हैव टू बी इन डिटेल एज इन दी कर्म देर फॉर भूयस्त्वात् मीनिंग बहुत्वात् मीनिंग कर्मांगास विच हैव टू बी इमेजिन्ड इन दी उपासनास आर ऑल्सो मेनी देर फॉर अनुबंधः therefore तु अनुबंधः however why does this upasana find itself in karmakanda in close proximity or in that prakarana because there is anubandha sambandha in this manner only because of lot of karmangas which have to be imagined in the upasanas therefore being closer to the karma and karmaanga it is easier to understand and then do this vidya separately do this upasana separately that is the idea there so page is shifted so that is sutra artha so vidya hai kriya agni na anubandha the kriya agni karmaanga there is a sambandha but it is not angaangi bhava sambandha it is a sambandha whereby being कर्मांगास बीइंग मोर इन दी उपासनास ऑल्सो दे हैव टू बी इमेजिन एंड देयर फोर इट फाइंड्स इट्स लेस इन दी विद संबंध दैट काइंड ऑफ संबंध इट फाइंड्स दी उपासना फाइंड्स इट्स लेस इन दी कर्मकांड प्रकरण द्विवृत्ति फॉलोज एज टू मानसिकाग्नि ब्रह्मणात् परेण ब्राह्मणेन शब्दस्य ताद्विद्यम सो मानसाग्नि ब्राह्मण दि ब्राह्मण विच talks about manasagni in the context parena brahmanena from that para what follows compared to this brahmana what is para what follows that brahmana parena brahmanena shabdasya tadvidyam so with this brahmana that follows what you see is that shabdasya tadvidyam It has tadvidyam meaning tadvida. It is of that type. Which type? The type that we are actually presenting, establishing in this Brahma Sutra Adhikarana. So tadvidyam is the svatantryam. So chityagnyam. लोकदृष्टि रूप स्वतंत्र विद्या विदित्वम् एव प्रतीयते सो इन एनालाइज यू सी व्हाट लोकदृष्टि रूप स्वतंत्र विद्या विदित्वम् व्हाट इज लोकदृष्टि व्हाट वी सॉ इन द लास्ट पार्ट इन द अर्लियर सूत्र द्युलोक दृष्टि सो द द्युलोक डिस्कशन दैट टेक्स प्लेस देयर वेयर द द्युलोक इज अग्नि एंड देन आदित्य इज ऑफर्ड एज समित That kind of an upasana is seen there. So, loka drushti, chityagnyam, loka drushti, rupa, swatantra vidya vidityam. Eva pratiyate. So, unto this agni, chityagni is the manaschita agni, the agni which is in as the part of upasana in the sorry, manasika agni, in the manas. So, manasika agni in that लोकदृष्टि रूप स्वतंत्र विद्या विदित्वमेव प्रतीयते दैट इज द्युलोक एंड दैट काइंड ऑफ अ दृष्टि इन द फॉर्म रूप इन अंटू दैट अग्नि दैट इज ऑल्सो मानस अग्नि विच हैज गॉन बाय देयर यू सी लोकदृष्टि द्युलोक दृष्टि काइंड ऑफ स्वतंत्र विद्या इट इज एन इंडिपेंडेंट उपासना विच प्रिस्क्राइब्स दैट एंड इट इज अ विधि ऑल्सो बिकॉज इट प्रिस्क्राइब्स दैट यू इमेजिन दिस अग्नि As Dhyuloka. That kind of a drishti you have in this Agni एव प्रतीयते देयर फॉर यू सी इट इज एन इंडिपेंडेंट उपासना ताद्विद्यम इज सीन चकारात ड्यू टू चकार परेण च मीन्स वॉट चकारात पूर्वेण अपि ब्राह्मणेन ब्राह्मणा दैट हैज गॉन बाय कंपेयर टू वॉट दिस मानसिक अग्नि ब्राह्मणात सो फ्रॉम दिस मानस अग्नि ब्राह्मणा दैट वी आर चेकिंग वेदर इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट और इट इज कर्मांगा देर यू सी the earlier brahmana which has gone by what not only what follows but what has gone by purvena api brahmanena mandala purusha upasti roopa swatantra vidya viditvameva drishyate mandala this is aditya mandala surya mandala so you have seen another also surya mandala also the purusha upasti that purusha is upasya and in which form roopa it is in the form of swatantra vidya only the vidhi is giving you In the Surya Mandala, you see Purusha. That Purusha is to be seen as, or Surya Mandala also, what it is, Agni Rupa. This kind of an imagination has to be done. Surya is different, Agni is different. You cannot exchange them. You cannot interchange them. But still, there is a Vidhi that you imagine this Agni and Surya Mandala as Surya Mandala Purusha. As Upasya, so there is a Swatantra Vidya Vidhitvam. There also, so what precedes and what follows, there you see Swatantra Vidya Vidhi and Vidhitvam Eva Drishyate Tat Sanidhyat because of having Sannidhi. How? By being sandwiched between these two independent Upasanas, Madhyasthena Api Brahmanena Manasagnina Swatantra Vidya Tvam Bodhyam. So you have to conclude that what is in between madhyasthena api with this also what is being prescribed with this brahmana manasagni nam swatantra vidya vidyatvam bodhyam I'm sorry just a moment sorry so you conclude that what is in between is also swatantra vidya it is a an independent upasana it is not karmaanga to the karma kanda or it is not upasana which is anga to karmaanga of the upasana it is not karmaanga or anga to the karmaanga it is not dependent on the karmaanga of the karma kanda nanu tarhi kasmat kriyagnina sahapata ityatah so the second half bhuyastvattu anubandha That is an answer to another Purvapaksha that comes up with this answer. Purvapaksha asks, Tarhi kasmat kriyagnina sahapataha. Why is this upasana read together in the prakarana of the kriyagni, karma agni, the physical agni? Ityataha. To this question, the answer given is bhuyastvattu anubandha in the sutra. To shanka nirasartha, that to is to refute the objection that has come up after saying that purvena and parena there is tadvidyam karmaanganam manasagni vidyayam sampadyanam bahutvat sampadya agnis are to be are the kalpita agnis in upasana sampat upasana in that manasagni upasana you have to imagine the many parts so upas whatever has to be imagined in upasana they are all sampadya And sampadyanam bahutvat, and they happen to be in the form of karmangas of the physical karma. So they have to have similar characteristics. So bahutvat, bhuyastvat is bahutvat because of there being many parts to the upasana which have to be imagined, and they are similar to the, they have to be similar to the way karma is being done. Therefore, vidyayah kriyagnina anubandha sahapatha. This anubandha, this sahapata itself is a sambandha. Finding itself in that section of the karma kanda, this itself is the sambandha of the upasana, independent upasana with the kriyagni. There is no real sambandha. Meaning, angangi bhava sambandha is not there. The sambandha is just being read together, that's all. Being Not as Eka Vakyata, read together in the sense, in the same section, this Brahmana also is there, which has no connection, but it is borrowing ideas or it is like the Upasana is a training which is given on the job. So on the physically you are doing something, you learn there and then take it to the upasana independently. Tasmadiyam manasagni vidya swatantra purushartha hetuhu iti siddham. Therefore, tasmad iyam manasagni vidya, this upasana vidya, which is manasagni, related to the fire which has to be kindled, maintained, lit up, etc. All of this in the mind itself. This is having hetu, which is for purushartha, swatantra purushartha. This purushartha is independent there. Now here the purushartha, a very tricky word to be used there, in the sense purushartha the way we know. So what it means is this, here purushartha, purushartha hetu, it is a hetu for purushartha. How can it be a purushartha hetu? How is upasana purushartha hetu? Of course, sukha is sought after by everyone, but what do we see? Dharmartha kama moksha, so dharma hetu. Swatantra dharma hetu can be seen, but then it leads to purushartha. Parama purushartha is moksha. So dharma, artha, kama and moksha. So dharmartha, and through that dharma, there is parama purushartha hetu also. Through ekagrata, and then what is the dhyana there really? So the vritti rupa agni is there. Agni is in the form of manasika vritti. So sarvesham vritti rupa agni, which is there, agnayaha, these have to be seen as what? All these agnis. Earlier we have seen in another adhikarana, we had seen that the entire life of a person is divided into 100 years, and each year is having 360 days. So 36,000 vrittis, with one vritti per day if you count, you get 36,000 vrittis in the entire lifespan. And this is what? This is, each of this vritti is seen as agni. So many agnis are there. All these vrittis are in the form of agni. So therefore you see, survey, all of these vrittis are seen as agnis, and they are what? These agnis are kindling and keeping my vrittis alive. So you check, look at all the vrittis, they are all in the form of agnis. This is the dhyana. And then whatever in the karma you are doing, whatever karma you are doing, they are in the form of vrittis. Now these individual vrittis are what? They are all agni. They are also equated to the karma, mean the physical karma, vaidika karma. So this vaidika karma, in a subtle manner, we have taken it into the vrittis. These vrittis are seen as agnis. Now these agnis, vritti roop, vritti agnis, are keeping my vrittis alive, and these, meaning the vaidika agni kind of agnis, which are in the form of the manasika agni, they are keeping my vrittis alive. In an entire life, they are keeping it alive. This is the dhyana. And then all the vrittis are having nama rupa. So when you look at all the nama rupas of the vrittis, first you have seen it as agni. Agnis are imagined in the mind. Then all the vrittis are also what? They are all manasika agnis. They are all what? They are kindled by this fire. Then each of these vrittis, which are on a per day basis, or whichever vrittis are taking place, they are having nama rupa, because there is tattad akara vritti. In tattad akara there is tattad nama also. So tattad nama, tattad akara vrittis are having chaitanya backing. This is where you have to land. That is the parama purushartha. So nama rupa, which is going to be taught as mithya in the Chandogya Upanishad Jnanakanda after this upasana, there nama rupani tyajyante chet, then sarvatra sarveshu brahma drishtireva shishyate, avashishyate. What remains is what after that? Chit brahma alone remains. In these vrittis also, there is a phalavyapti. Phalavyapti is due to chaitanya, brahma chaitanya. So excuse my voice is a little more coarse today. So when you drop the nama and rupa, you land on Brahma Chaitanya. That would be the Parama Purusharta Siddhi as well. So Swatantra Purusharta Hetu. So Manasa Agni Vidya has Swatantra Purusharta Hetutu. Iti Siddham. This is established and thereby this long Adhikarana comes to an end. Just give me a moment, please. I need a sip of water. So thereby this Adhikarana, long Adhikarana is over. Now the next Adhikarana is introduced by saying, Nanu Vidyayaha Purusharta Hetuttam Ayuktam. Pura Paksha is objecting, saying that this Vidyas, all these three, in Purva Para Brahmana or currently what is under discussion as a single Vidya. When you look at it as a single Vidya, independent of the karma, then he says Purushartha Hetu, it cannot be. So Purushartha Hetuttam Ayuktam, it is not right, says the Purvapakshi. Why so? Now this Purvapakshi is a Charvaka here, or with Charvaka kind of a thinking. Dehadi vetiriktasya purushasya abhavat. Iti akshepa sangatya idama. There is an akshepa sangati. Purvapakshi is objecting that other than deha sharira ityadi, there is no other purusha. So what purushartha? Purushartha finally is what? If you look at it, the samasa, generally what is said? Purushaihi Archyate Prapyate iti Purushartha. That is the Vyutpatti. That is the Vigravakya. Purushartha means sorry, what is sought after by the people. But here if you can also look at it, Purushartha Parama Purushartha is Moksha. So Purushaya or Purusha Arthaha Prayojanam Yasya. That kind of a meaning is being seen by the, it appears as being seen by the Purvapakshi. So he is saying there is no other Purusha for whom, me Tadarte Chaturthi kind of a meaning, Artha tells you that it is Tadarte, Purushaya kind of a meaning. Either a Bahuri, with an Artha ending word you can make a Bahuri, the meaning is what? Purushaya ityartha, the Purvapada, it will be in Chaturthi kind of a meaning, that will be the final meaning, Purushaya, Tadarte Chaturthi, for the purpose of Purusha. So Purusha Prapti. And this Purusha is who? Who is this Purusha? What will you attain? Who will attain? So if you look at Dehadi, is the Purusha, says the Purvapakshi. There is no other Purusha other than this Dehadi Purusha. So Dehadi Vyatiriktasya Purushasya Abhava. There is no other Purusha for whom one would do any Upasana, etc. Iti Akshepa Sangatya Idamaha. This is the Akshepa and thereby Ekatmya Adhikaranam has come up. So Purvapakshi Sutra, there is Ekatmana Sharire Bhavat. Ek Atmana Sharire Bhavat. The Padachheda is Eke. Eke are the Eke Atmanaha Sharire Bhavat. So Eke, Eke, some say. Eke, who are those? Charvakaha Sharire Atmanaha Bhavat. Sharire sati atmana bhava. So what are tesham shariram eva atma? So this is a hetu given for the conclusion that sharira itself is atma. Shariram eva atma. Why? Because sharire sati atmana bhavat. That is the अन्वय व्यतिरेक संबंध एज सीन बाय दी पूर्व पक्षी चारवाका दे से दैट ओनली वेन शरीर इज देर यू सी आत्मा यू सी बिहेवियर ऑफ आत्मा वॉट एवर आत्मा यू आर कंसिडरिंग आत्मा पुरुष दैट इज देर ओनली वेन शरीर इज देर वेन शरीर इज नॉट देर वेर इज द आत्मा देर फोर शरीर इट सेल्फ इज आत्मा शरीरे आत्मनः भावात् शरीरे सति सति सत्यं शरीरे सति एव आत्मनः भावात् इति एके एके चार्वाकः आहु तेषां तेषां चार्वाकाणां और लोकायतानां शरीरम एव आत्मा और पुरुषः दिस इज द सूत्रार्थ प्रसंगादस्य पादसंगतिर् बोध्य देयर इज अ प्रसंग संगति इट हैज कम अप इन अ कॉन्टेक्स्ट इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद द उपासना बट What has been said by the Siddhanti is that this Anubandha etc. shows that there is a Sambandha of this Vidya with the Karma Kanda by just being mere presence there. That itself is due to the Bahutva, Bahulya of the Upasana Angas, parts of the Upasanas which have Karma Anga. Karmanga kind of characteristics, therefore they are read together. But then this does not lead to the sutra. So Vritti is explaining as to what Swatantra Purusharta Hetu. So when you say it is an independent Vidya, what is the phala of that Vidya you have to mention? So the explanation was given as to Bhagavan Sutrakara means that there is an independent Upasana which will lead to Parama Purusharta in the Jnana Kanda that follows. It will connect in that manner. It has no such connection with the karma, with the angangi bhava, but this will lead to via chitta ekagrata and an advanced understanding that follows. This upasana will aid that because while you are doing the upasanas, the physical activities have been converted into mental activities. And then you can see that nama and rupa if you drop, then the jnana which follows is very easy. This is how the connection has come up. In the vritti, Bhagavan Sadashiv Brahmendra has explained that this is the mind of the sutrakara. Now, Purvapakshi is saying that this is itself not possible because there is no other purusha at all. That is the prasanga sangati there. फलम तो पूर्वपक्षे देहादि व्यतिरिक्त आत्म अभावात् स्वर्गापवर्गादि शास्त्र वैयर्थ्यम् सो दिस पूर्वपक्षी चार्वाका हैज एब्सोल्युटली नथिंग टू डू विथ योर उपासना इनटू पुरुषार्थ एज इन आत्मज्ञान बिकॉज देर इज नो आत्मा सेपरेट फ्रॉम शरीर सो दिस चार्वाका हैज is saying that all that you have built up so far is useless because the Shastra itself has no prayojana. That is his perspective. Therefore, he is saying in Purvapaksha there is no other Purusha Atma other than Dehadi, Deha, Manas, Ityadi, Buddhi, Indriyas. Therefore, Swarga, Apavargadi, Shastra, Vayartyam. That which will take you to Swarga or will lead to Moksha, Apavarga, all this Shastra is meaningless. Dharmartha, Kama, Purusharta, all these Purusharthas are not really there. There is only actually what he is looking at. There is no Dharma. There is no Moksha. So what remains is Artha and Kama. Artha and Kama are seen in animals also. So he says that is all there is and which can be learnt without the Shastra. Therefore, Shastra Vayartyam. For Dharma and Moksha, which talk about Atma separate from the body, that doesn't exist. Therefore, Dharma and the Swarga Apavargadi Shastra is meaningless. So, two Purusharthas are gone. What is left are other two Purusharthas. For that, he says, I don't need Shastra at all. Because in Loka itself, there is Artha and Kama. Therefore, the Shastra is Vyartha. Siddhanti tat sarthakyam iti phalabheda. Siddhanti says that Shastras are meaningful. In fact, Shastras are the only pramana for Dharma and Moksha. And Artha and Kama, if it is attained with the, that those two Purusharthas also, when they are attained with Dharma as the guideline, then Moksha is easy to be led to. It becomes a Parama Purushartha, not only Parama Purushartha, first Parama Purushartha, then Ekameva Purushartha, and then finally इट कैन बी अटेन्ड। अत्र आत्मा विषय, व्हाट इज द विषय, आत्मा इट्सेल्फ इज द विषय, बिकॉज पूर्व पक्षी इज नॉट गोइंग टू टेक सम अधिक दिस अधिकरण टू हैव कनेक्शन विथ श्रुति, बिकॉज ही डज नॉट कंसिडर श्रुति इट्सेल्फ एज प्रमाण। सो इवन इफ यू ब्रिंग सम श्रुति एज प्रमाण, ही इज गोइंग टू से दैट इज नॉट द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ डिस्कशन एट ऑल, बिकॉज ही डज नॉट केयर फॉर इट। ही इज अ चार्वाका, नास्तिक। देयरफॉर अत्र आत्मा विषय, व्हाट इज आत्मा, व्हाट डज इट मीन बाय आई द सेल्फ। सो देयर स किम देह एव उत तद अतिरिक्त इति संशये, व्हेन देयर इज अ डाउट वेदर इट इज दिस आत्मा इज द बॉडी और समथिंग अदर देन द बॉडी इति संशय, तत्र एके एके दैट इज द सूत्र एके, हु आर दोस लोका इति का, तत्र एके लोका इति कहा, शरीर अतिरिक्तस्य व्यतिरिक्तस्य आत्मन असत्त्वं मन्यमानः, दोज हु आर कंसीडरिंग, मन्यमान शानचंत, दोज हु आर कंसीडरिंग असत्त्वं अभाव, एब्सेंस ऑफ व्हाट, अनरियलिटी ऑफ आत्मा विच इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दिस शरीर बॉडी, दोज आर लोका इति कहा चार्वाका, दे से व्हाट शरीरम एव आत्मा इति आशक्षते, they state that sharira itself is atma, what other atma are you discussing of, kutaha, why so, hetu given is sharire asti iti upalabdhehe bhavat, because sharire sati, when the sharira is there then only asti, this he a person is there, when the sharira is gone then we say oh the person is gone, therefore what, due to such an upalabdhi, you see such prayoga, it is pratyaksha siddha says the purva pakshi, तदभावे च अभावात्, एंड व्हेन द शरीर इज गॉन आत्मा आल्सो व्हाट एवर यू आर क्लेमिंग दैट सेंशियंस इज आल्सो नो लॉन्गर देयर इति अन्वय व्यतिरेकाभ्याम तस्याः शरीर धर्मत्वेन अतिरिक्त आत्मा सिद्धेः, आत्मनः असिद्धे विच आत्मा विच इज अतिरिक्त डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट शरीर धर्मत्वेन अतिरिक्तस्य, व्हाट एवर इज द आत्मा that you are seeing, which you are trying to establish, that cannot be established separate from the sharira dharma. Iti purva paksha. This is the purva paksha. What is the siddhanta answer to that? Siddhanti says, siddhantastu vyatirekastad bhava bhavitvan natu palabdhivat. Vyatirekastad bhava bhavitvan natu palabdhivat. So, vyatirekaha तद्भावाभावित्वात् न तु उपलब्धिवत्, दैट इज द पदच्छेद। सो व्यतिरेक, देर इज व्यतिरेक, देर इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन व्हाट, बिटवीन शरीर एंड आत्मा, शरीरात व्यतिरेक आत्मा, आत्मनः आत्मा इज डिफरेंट, डेफिनेटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम शरीर, हाउ सो, सो दिस न इज देर एज अ रिफ्यूटेशन, न न तथा, as the purva pakshi says tatha nasti, why atmanah vyatireka, atmanah sharirat vyatireka, it is different from the sharira, what, why tad bhava bhavitva, that is the hetu, tad bhava abhavitvat, meaning what, tad bhave sharira, tad is sharira, तद्भावे अपि शरीराद् व्यतिरेकः तद्भावे अपि उपलब्धेः अभावित्वात्, मीनिंग व्हाट, तद्भावे व्हेन दी मरण, व्हाट इज मरण रियली, शरीर इज नॉट गॉन, वेर इज द शरीर, शरीर इज गॉन ओनली व्हेन यू बर्न इट, बट मरण इज प्रायर टू बर्निंग द शरीर, सॉरी श्रीधर, so marana is before the sharira is burnt, only then you burn the sharira, so sharira is still there, so tadbhave, samasa is tadbhave abhavitvat, tadbhave kasya abhavitvat upalabdhe, the upalabdhi hetu that is given by the purvapakshi bhavat, upalabdhe bhavat, that is what is the claim made by the purvapakshi in the earlier 53rd sutra. So in 54th, as a refutation, Purva Pakshi is being answered by the Siddhanti that Abhavitvat, na bhavat, Abhavitvat, kasya upalabdehe Abhavitvat. उपलब्धि दैट यू आर क्लेमिंग आत्मा इज देयर एटसेट्रा ही सेज इफ यू आर सेइंग एज लॉन्ग एज शरीरा इज देयर देयर इज उपलब्धि शरीरा इज देयर इन मरणा वेर इज द उपलब्धि ऑफ आत्मा देयर आत्मा उपलब्धि इज नॉट हैविंग अन्वय व्यतिरिका विद द शरीर एट ऑल इट कीप्स द शरीर अलाइव बट देन आत्मा उपलब्धि वेर इज द आत्मा आत्मा उपलब्धि इज व्हाट इट इज देयर अस्थि भाति प्रियम सो अस्थि भाति प्रियम ऑल आर मिसिंग वेन द शरीर इज देयर इन मरण बट अस्थि भाति प्रियम आर नॉट देयर सो वेर इज द आत्मा सो उपलब्धि है अभावित्वात् कदा तद्भावे शरीर भावे सति मरण अवस्थायां शरीर भावे सति अपि आत्मनः अभावित्वात् न व्हाट देयर इज नो अन्वय व्यतिरेका पॉसिबल दैट यू आर शोइंग इट देयर इज नो सच अन्वय व्यतिरेका विच एस्टैब्लिश शरीर इटसेल्फ इज आत्मा देयरफॉर व्हाट आत्मनः शरीरात् व्यतिरेका सो दिस हेतु इज लीडिंग टू व्यतिरेक ऑफ आत्मा डिफरेंस ऑफ आत्मा फ्रॉम द शरीर एंड देन वॉट उपलब्धिवत टू उपलब्धिवत दिस इज एन एग्जाम्पल बिकॉज हेतु हैज बीन गिवन एग्जाम्पल इज नीडेड सो यथा उपलब्धि ही शरीरात अन्या उपलब्धिवत सो यू सी द उपलब्धि ऑफ समथिंग इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द शरीर There are other things which are available as different from the sharira, similar to them. So whatever is available separate from the sharira, similar is this atma which is available separate from the sharira. Therefore, there is difference. Sorry. Or what is there? For example, the upalabdhi of what upalabdhi can be established with what the knowledge or cognition. So knowledge or cognition is separate from the Sharira. In Swapna also you have Jnana that is separate from the Sharira. Stula Sharira is not there then. In Swapna the Stula Sharira is not there. So the Purva Pakshi claiming what? Where is that? Sharira Dharmatvena Atirikta Atma Asidde the Sharira Dharmas. Other than Sharira Dharma, you don't have Atma Dharmas. That is the claim being made. So, Upalabdhivat meaning there are Dharmas which are seen, which are separate from the Sharira Dharmas. That is the Upalabdhivat. Meaning what? It will be clear in the Vritti. It's a little tricky to explain because it will be repeated in the Vritti, but many ways it can be understood. The vritti is going to explain that just like upalabdhi of anything is separate from not only one I explained from the sharira. Sharira of what? Not only human sharira. If you look at it, upalabdhi. Ghataha asti. So ghata upalabdhi is there. Asti, astitva of the ghata and the ghata are they one and the same? So upalabdhi of the ghata is astitva of the ghata. That astitva of the ghata and ghata itself are different from each other. Because astitva as a dharma of ghata is seen elsewhere also. If it is one with the ghata, then it can't be in the pata. You say pata is also what? Pata asti. This is something that we have seen in under Gita Bhashya. Nasato vidyate bhava ityadi in that shloka under that there is a long discussion where Bhagavan Bhashyakara establishes that the astitva does not belong to the padartha. Ghata's astitvam is not what ghata is because astitva of the ghata is seen in I am saying in the pata but there he explains as to ghata when the ghata is broken then what happens to the ghata's astitvam? Purva Pakshi said it is gone. It is not gone. Astitva is seen in the pieces of the ghata now. Otherwise, if astitva goes away, then it cannot be seen elsewhere. If the ghata is broken, astitva also is broken. If that is the case, then astitva cannot be seen in the pieces of the ghata. So you say pot is there. Once the pot is broken, you don't say that the pot is there, but you say is there. That is there shift to what? Pieces of the pot. So pieces of the pot are there now. Is there or are there? So astitva has shifted from the pot to the shards of the pot. So astitva has not gone anywhere. Astitva is definitely there. That is what is said by Bhagavan Krishna. Nasato vidyate bhavaha. Asata bhavaha na vidyate. And further what? Sataha abhavaha na vidyate. So there is no abhava of sat. Astitva cannot have any abhava. So this is what is meant by upalabdhi. Upalabdhi is presence of something. Presence of something is different from that something itself. It is not something. It is the presence is not itself the thing, but presence is separate from the thing. From the vastu it is different. And it is the real vastu. Astitva is the real vastu. Vasati iti vastu. Ghata is there. It is gone now. So astitva has trikala satta baditvam. Trikala abadita is the satta astitvam, whereas ghata does not have trikala abadittvam. It wasn't there before creation of the pot and it is not there. The pot is not there after the destruction of the pot. But the satta was there before in the clay. It was seen in the pot after the pot's creation, and after the destruction of the pot, it is seen in the pieces of the pot. Therefore, satta is separate from the, upalabdhi is separate from the ghata. Similarly, what? Sharirad anya. Upalabdhi sharirad anya. It is not same as. So, upalabdhi is really what? Atmana upalabdhi is astitva, and that astitva is the very nature of the atma. So, sharira dharma, dharmatvena atirikta atma asiddhehe is countered by saying upalabdhi vateva. Like the upalabdhi of the ghata is separate from the ghata, similarly, the astitva, atmana astitvam, atma swarupa is separate from the sharira dharma. Astitva is not sharira dharma, it is atma dharma, it is the very swarupa of atma. It is the lakshana, very lakshana of the atma, very definition, that is the swarupa lakshana. So this is the sutra artha. The vritti says, natu atmanah sharirad avyatirekah. Sharirad atmanah avyatirekah na. So vyatirekah, it is separate. Kintu vyatirekah eva. Vyatirekah is in the sutra. So what is na? This na is what you are claiming, that kind of a avyatirekah, meaning non-difference from sharira is not established with your anvaya vyatireka, because that kind of anvaya vyatireka is not there. That is shown in the hetu. So kim nasti sharirad avyatiriktum atmanah avyatiriktatvam nasti. So vyatirekatvam asti. So vyatireka eva. Kintu vyatireka eva, meaning sharira is one and atma is another. Atma is different from the sharira. Kutha. Sorry, what is the reason? तस्य शरीरस्य मरणावस्थायां भावे अपि तद् भावे अपि शरीर भावे अपि इवन व्हेन द शरीर इज एक्जिस्टेंट शरीर इज देयर इन द मरण अवस्था उपलब्धि रूप आत्मधर्मस्य अभावित्वात् यू डोंट सी उपलब्धि विच इज द आत्मधर्म अस्तित्व विच इज द आत्मधर्म दैट यू डू नॉट सी इन द upalabdhi. Upalabdhi has more meaning than just astitvam. Shariram, sharira is there, but upalabdhi is what, as meant by the purva pakshi, upalabdhi is the sentience that you see. That sentience you do not see in the sharira after, in the death. In the state of death, you don't see that upalabdhi of bhana. That bhana is not there. So upalabdhi is actually sachidananda. So that Satchidananda upalabdhi claimed by the Siddhanti, Purva Pakshi is saying It is not separate from the sharira. Siddhanti proves that it is separate because in the marana, before the body is burnt, that body has astitva all right, but there is no bhana upalabdhi. Abhavitvat patane cha tasya sharirasya shariraantara avachedena taddharmasya bhavitvat. And even further what? The sharira has gone. Patane, sharira patana has happened, but even then what? Tasya sharirasya shariraantara avachedena taddharmasya bhavitvat. In the form of another sharira it is there. In another sharira you find this asti bhati priya. Therefore, this asti bhati priya kind of upalabdhi is separate from the sharira itself. Because you don't need this sharira to be disintegrated and come together in the form of another sharira to see the taddharma, the upalabdhi dharma. You can see this upalabdhi dharma in other shariras. The person who has died is survived by others. So those survivors, there is an upalabdhi. Therefore, this upalabdhi that we talk of is definitely separate from the sharira. That is what we call as atma, and it is not sharira dharma, no sharira dharmatvam. Upalabdhivat. And upalabdhivat example is yatha bhuto upalabdhi na tad dharma. Na tad dharma means na bhuta dharma. The panchamahabhutas or the ghatapata ityadi vastus, their upalabdhi, which we saw in the sutra, explained this. So, the upalabdhi is not dharma of the ghatapatadi or the panchamahabhutas tataha vyatirichyate. It is separate. Tatha bhautika deha upalabdhi na tad dharma. The bhautika, the panchamahabhutas products, bhautika. So, with bhuta you can take the panchamahabhutas because bhautika shabda has been used, not ghatapatadi. So, the just like the now, here there is an interesting argument by the Purvapakshi, which can be seen as the modern science also using. See, what is this upalabdhi? For the Siddhanti, it is Sachidananda. For the Purvapakshi, it is only Bhana. Only Bhana can be seen. Satta may be there, but his interest is to see the Bhana, meaning the Chaitanya. The consciousness that you see is a product. Charvaka says it's a product of four Mahabhutas coming together. He does not, meaning Charvakas do not care for the Akasha Mahabhuta. So they don't talk of Pancha Mahabhutas, they talk about only four Mahabhutas. And they say what is the Chaitanya? Chaitanya consciousness is an end result when the four elements come together, the great elements, Mahabhutas come together. So when Prithvi, Jala, Agni and Vayu come together, then what happens that this Sharira which is made, that suddenly has sentience, consciousness. This is what modern science also says, when the parts come together, then somehow consciousness is born, which is not agreeable to Shastra. Siddhanta is not like that, consciousness is not born. Now that is what Purvapakshi, that kind of Purvapaksha is being countered as yatha bhuto upalabdhihi na tad dharmaha. So taking their own darshana, we ask them, what is this consciousness? Is it part of Prithvi? Is it Prithvi dharma? They say no. They also will say it is not Prithvi dharma. Otherwise in suddenly the if the Prithvi is conscious, Prithvi Mahabhuta is not conscious. They also agree. It is not conscious. Then what about the Jala? Jala is not conscious. It is not sentient. Then what about Vayu, Agni? What about Vayu? So none of them are conscious. They are not sentient. But when they come together, there is sentience. So therefore what? Bhuta Upalabdhihi, that Bhana sentience that you see, Upalabdhi of Mahabhutas, be it four. Is it the Mahabhuta Dharma? No. That Purvapakshi agrees. So we need something as an example where both parties agree, and then you can extend it to the next exemplified ततः व्यतिरिच्यते दैट धर्म सेंशियंस इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द इंडिपेंडेंट महाभूतास विच इज एग्रीएबल टू द पूर्व पक्षी चारवाका तथा भौतिक देहो उपलब्धि ही न तद्धर्म. सिमिलरली वॉट द प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ दी पृथ्वी जल इत्यादि भौतिक वेन दे कम टूगेदर ऑल्सो देह इज फॉर्म. सो भौतिक देह इज वॉट इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम दी भौतिक धर्म उपलब्धि. सो भौतिक देह उपलब्धि न तद्धर्म मीनिंग भौतिक धर्म नास्ति भौतिक देह धर्म नास्ति इट इज नॉट शरीर धर्म. सो वॉट यू आर सेइंग शरीर धर्म एंड आत्मधर्म एंड वन आर द सेम दे आर नॉट. The Atmadharma is separate. Sentience is consciousness is separate from the Bhautika, just like sentience is separate from the Bhuta, which is the element. So just like the element, consciousness is not the Dharma of independent elements. When they are together, the elemental cannot have consciousness. The consciousness is separate from the elemental also. साव उपलब्धि अस्माकम् आत्मा इति देह व्यतिरिक्तस्य आत्मन सत्वम् इति सिद्धम् एंड देयर बाय सिद्धांति हैज एस्टैब्लिश्ड व्हाट सत्वम् एस्टैब्लिश्ड द प्रेजेंस ऑफ आत्मा सेपरेट फ्रॉम द देह देह व्यतिरिक्त एंड व्हाट इज इट साव उपलब्धि बिकॉज स्वरूप लक्षण मीन्स व्हाट कॉन्शियसनेस इज स्वरूप लक्षण दैट इटसेल्फ इज आत्मा. अस्माकम् आत्मा अस्माकम् मते साव आत्मा साव का साव उपलब्धि आत्मा दैट उपलब्धि विच वी कॉल एज सत्ता स्फूर्ति भान आनंद ऑल ऑफ दोज वर्ड्स आर बेसिकली आत्मा इट्सेल्फ नथिंग अदर देन आत्मा एंड देयर फोर इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट आत्मा इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम द शरीर. दिस एंड्स द अधिकरण एंड वील लुक एट द 31st अधिकरण 55th सूत्र इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ. आम्ना यंते के समसिद्ध आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनवा पूर्ण आत्म ज्योति उपासमहे. नमस्ते धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद नमस्ते.